If you would like to enjoy all my work ad-free, as well as exclusive Sleepy Cat stories and more perks, then please consider becoming a patron and supporting this channel at patreon.com/sleepycatmeditations. Thank you so much to each and every one of you who have already helped Sleepy Cat along the way. You make all of this possible. And now, I hope you enjoy tonight's creation. A warm welcome to You're a Wizard, a magical sleep saga inspired by the world of Harry Potter, where you are the main character. As you take a moment to get comfortable, remind yourself that this is your story, and there are no limits to what you can add to this adventure. Anyone that you meet along the way throughout this saga can be whoever you want them to be. They might be people from your own life, a famous figure that you admire, or a character from the books. So be sure to bring along your own unique imagination. Begin by making yourself nice and comfortable where you are, and give yourself permission to let go of everything tonight. This is your story and your adventure. And when you are ready, just allow the eyelids to feel heavier and heavier until they gently close. Before we begin, we will do a short guided breathing pattern called 3-4-5. This will allow you to slow down and relax, preparing your body and your mind for a wonderful, peaceful rest. When you are ready, breathe in through the nose for 3. Hold for 4. And breathe out for 5. Let all of it go now. Again, that's in for 3. Hold for 4. And release, blowing away the thoughts of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Again, in for 3. Hold. And let it go. Continue to breathe in this way in your own time, and with each breath out, allow your body to sink just that bit deeper into your mattress. And now, allow the breath to fall back into a natural rhythm. Enjoy this new relaxation flowing through your body. Let your thoughts turn to those of magic, wonder, and adventure as we continue our Harry Potter sleep saga. The cobbled road in front of you, leading over a little bridge and into the village, is covered with a layer of leaves, guiding your way down a golden brown path. As you wander over the bridge and towards the village, you notice the many chimneys puffing away in a steady rhythm, and the soft silver haze mingles over the rooftops, guarding this land with an enchanted mist. It is a perfect picture to behold. Before you know it, you begin to weave your way through the narrow streets of the village, filled with a wonderful parade of magical shops and cozy cottages. All around you are pockets of students, professors, and local villagers, talking away happily or simply enjoying this wonderful place. Each building has their own unique character and color, and all have two bay windows that protrude from the brick on each side of their front door. You pass an old enchanted shoemaker with a red door and golden windows. Inside, lit by a dim lamplight, is a grey-haired wizard in a ruby waistcoat, tending to an old pair of boots. The shelves are peppered with odds and ends, bits of leather, shoelaces, and other trinkets. Next is the green door of the apothecary, with thick plant life sprawling up the cobblestone. The windows are lined with fairy lights and filled with exotic plants of many colors. There is a sweet shop with a bright orange door, packed with an endless array of Halloween treats. Its windows are littered with mini pumpkin lanterns bobbing up and down, and bubbling pots of sticky candy stirring by themselves. Inside are other students or families with young children, positively overwhelmed by the many magical treats around them. To your left is a dark door with a silver handle, and black windows illuminate a soft golden light. On display are floating tweed suits, wizarding robes, or fancy hats. Here resides the village tailor. If there is any damage to your robes, or any sudden growth spurts, then this is the place to come for a slight readjustment. You pass by a charming little tea room, decorated in striped colors of pastel blue and baby pink, with hanging flower baskets on each side of the door. There is a colorful display of magical desserts filling the window, and the smell of hot chocolate and fresh pastry drifts out into the street. And finally, as you come to the end of the street, the village opens up, revealing the thatched roof of the tavern, with a proud puffing chimney and three broomsticks hanging over the main door. This is the reason you came here today, to sit in peace and quiet with your best friend and enjoy the one thing you have both been craving, a butterbeer. Without another hesitation, you push open the heavy door of the tavern, and you are met with a blast of heat that soothes your body with a gentle warmth. Inside, the tavern is almost empty. One or two wizards are perched at the bar, enjoying an afternoon drink, or sat in a far corner, sharing a quiet conversation. A young, green-eyed witch is cleaning tankards behind the bar, no doubt preparing for the evening rush. She gives you a warm smile and simply asks, "Butterbeer, is it?" You thank her with a smile and remove your coat, hanging it by the door. You take off your woolly hat and shuffle it into your coat pocket. Your best friend leads the way towards the middle of the tavern, and you find two armchairs in front of a little log fire. You flop down into this soft, sinking armchair and pull a thick blanket over your legs. You take a slow, deep breath, enjoying this wonderful moment of quiet and comfort. There is no work to be done, no worries to concern you, and nothing to think about now. This atmosphere is absolutely perfect. Suddenly, the young witch appears again, carrying two big tankards, full to the brim. She places them down on the little table at your knees, and you thank her, handing over three sickles each. You share a quiet moment with your friend as you clink your tankards together. You have 100 things you could say, but there is no need to. You are simply happy to be together, just the two of you, on this wonderful adventure. You take a sip of your cold, refreshing butterbeer that is a beautiful contrast to the hot, crackling fire warming your body. You feel this refreshment tingle over your lips and into your mouth, bringing a smile to your face. And with every little mouthful, you allow this delicious drink to run through your body and relax each muscle as you sink deeper and deeper into your armchair. You feel your chest and your stomach becoming free as a soft comfort washes over you. With a satisfied sigh, you begin to talk away with your best friend as you curl up in your chair, enjoying your magical drink and the soothing warmth of the fire. You reminisce on the beautiful memories that you have, and fantasize about future adventures, places you would like to go, and things you would like to do together. You share your secrets now and tell each other your hopes and dreams. It has been a busy term for you, and it is rare to have this time with your friend. You treasure this moment, just the two of you, as thick as thieves, and a world of magic ahead of you. As you finish the last drop of butterbeer, you hear the tavern door swing open, and the silhouette of a huge man stands in the doorway. The soft light of the fire reveals the face of your gentle giant. With a knowing smile, he tells you that Daphne said he might find you here. The giant has a surprise for you, and when you are ready, you are to meet him outside. As he leaves the tavern, he gives a low chuckle, admitting that there are actually two surprises. With a sudden burst of energy, you share an excited smile with your friend. You walk over to the doorway, shuffle on your coat and your hat, and bid farewell to the young witch at the bar. She gives you a smile, letting you know that you are welcome here anytime. You push open the door and head back out into the fresh autumn air. Outside, you are met by a beautiful sunset, shimmering in orange and purple through the mist of the chimneys and twinkling over the golden leaves. As you walk side by side with the giant along a winding path out of the village, he tells you that the first surprise tonight is a little adventure together, delving into the forbidden forest. It is the turn of the season, he tells you, and as autumn moves to winter, the centaurs will begin a magical parade across the forest in celebration of the new moon, in centaur tradition at least. It is a wonderful display, the giant adds, and the king of the centaurs has given him permission to bring you along for the ride. This is an ancient ceremony, and so we must be polite, respectful, and on our very best behavior. You round a cluster of trees and emerge right outside the giant's hut that is surrounded by a magnificent collection of pumpkins. They range from the size of an apple to many of them coming above your waist. The pumpkins pulse in a rich orange, giving off a wonderful magic. You wander through the pumpkin patch, taking in the fantastic display, and your gentle giant gives a proud smile as you stare in awe at the sight all around you. As you reach the end of the patch and arrive at the hut, the giant tells you to wait there a moment as he wanders up to his door. He turns now, giving a mischievous smile, saying, "I almost forgot about your second surprise." And with that, the giant swings open his front door. In the next moment, you are greeted by the black and white sleepy cat running out of the hut and down the stone steps. They run up to you, tail in the air, and you kneel down to meet them. They greet you with happy meows and brush their soft head against your hand as they roll onto their back, demanding a belly rub. You tickle their tummy and tell them just how much you have missed them. The sleepy cat jumps up into your arms and curls up in complete comfort, and an overwhelming joy washes over you. You cannot believe it, your oldest friend and guardian. The giant tells you he went back to the alley this morning after breakfast to collect this naughty little cat. They seemed to be expecting him, he adds, and have been desperate to see you since they arrived. You thank your gentle giant with a happy smile, and the warmth from this little cat's heart runs through your body, and you know that you are completely protected. No matter where life takes you, your little sleepy cat will always be here to guide your way or to soothe your heart whenever you need it. You are companions for life. In the next moment, the giant tells you that it's time to head into the forest. The sun has almost set, and the changing of the moons is about to begin. And with that, you put your lovely cat back down, and they trot alongside you now, occasionally wrapping their tail around your leg. You arrive at the borders of the forest, and in front of you is a familiar hollow tree. As you get closer, you can see, perched on one of the branches, are two of the fluffy animals from your very first lesson in care of magical creatures. The smallest of the two is your furry friend, and they are already hopping around excitedly at the sight of you. The gentle giant picks up the two little animals and hands them to you and your best friend. You place your fluffy companion on your shoulder now, ready to bring them along on this magical adventure. You whisper to them that they will be safe with you, and they tuck in closer on your shoulder, their soft fur tickling on your neck. And just then, as you are about to take your first step inside the forest, you are met by the little elf Daphne, who appears out of thin air. She has been racing around the castle, finishing her work as quickly as she can, so that she can join you for the changing of the moons. It seems she found you just in time. You take this moment to appreciate all of your wonderful companions. The gentle giant in front of you, your furry animal on your shoulder, the black and white sleepy cat at your feet, your lovely elf Daphne, and of course your best friend by your side. And now your group slowly steps inside the first line of trees, pushing through the thick leaves and entering the forbidden forest.